好，各位傳媒嘅朋友，大家好。喺九月五號星期三，毒品調查科探員喺新界上水一個私人住宅嘅屋苑咧，盜破咗一個稀釋同埋包裝可卡因毒品嘅工場，拘捕咗兩名本地嘅男子，檢獲咗15.5公斤嘅可卡因，市值係1530萬港元嘅，43公斤。用嚟稀釋可卡因嘅第一步毒藥，一啲包裝嘅工具添。咁其後咧，探員亦都喺其中一名被捕人士嘅住所裏邊咧，檢獲120萬斯兒販毒嘅得益。咁詳細案情咧，我哋而家交俾毒品調查科吳永思警司跟大家講一講。
好，大家好。毒品調查科嘅探員根據調查同埋線報咧，我哋喺啱啱星期三9月5號嘅朝早9點零鐘左右咧，喺一個上水嘅私人屋苑進行呢個反毒品行動。期間咧，我哋截獲咗兩名男子，就喺佢哋喺嗰個大廈裡面嘅一個單位出嚟嘅時候咧。呢兩名男子咧，分別就係43歲姓陳梁，同埋53歲姓陳嘅男子。咁43歲姓梁嘅男子咧，就係上址嘅租客嚟嘅。咁經過搜查咧，就發現喺姓梁嘅男子嘅背囊裡面咧，係有11公斤嘅斯兒可卡因。探員咧就當場以販運危險藥物嘅罪名咧，拘捕咗佢哋兩個。其後我哋將佢帶翻去單位裡面搜查。喺單位裏面咧，再發現咧有4.5公斤嘅斯兒可卡因啦，43公斤係我哋相信係用嚟稀釋可卡因用嘅第一步毒藥。另外咧，仲有一批稀釋同埋包裝毒品嘅工具，譬如係攪拌機啦、電子磅。仲有咧，就係有大家都見到呢度有一個叫做液壓嘅千斤頂啦，同埋呢個鋼造嘅工作台，咁啊嗰邊個實物大家都見到，同埋咧仲有磚狀嘅倒模啦，好多嘅膠卷咁樣嘅。於是咧，探員咧將呢兩名男子咧再拘捕另一個罪名咧，就係製造危險藥物嘅。其後咧，我哋咧帶呢個姓梁嘅男子去到佢新田嘅住宅咧，喺佢單位裏面咧就發現約摸120萬港元嘅現金，涉嫌咧呢啲係販毒嘅得益。呢兩名男子咧已經喺今早咧因為俾我哋落案咗啦，咁咧就喺今早嘅粉嶺嘅裁判院提堂嘅。我哋相信咧，今次嘅行動咧已經倒破咗一個稀釋同埋包裝可卡因嘅工場，並且堵截咗大量嘅可卡因啦，就令到佢唔能夠流入本地嘅市場嘅。喺行動裡面咧，我哋亦都檢獲咗唔少嘅稀釋毒品嘅工具，譬如3個共重紅色嗰啲咧，就係每一個咧重40磅嘅液壓千斤頂，2個。差唔多每一個咧係有挨近400磅嘅鋼製嘅工作台啦，同埋有唔同大小嘅磚形嘅帽啦，係比較近年嚟咧係非常之罕見嘅。初步調查得知咧，我哋就係呢個販毒集團咧，為咗進一步謀取更多嘅利潤咧，佢哋首先咧係會將第一步嗰個毒藥咧就會混入喺可卡因裡面以稀釋嘅作用啦。其後咧就會用嗰個千斤頂咧就同埋個工作台咧就用同埋磚模咧就將混合完嘅可卡因咧壓成磚狀，跟住咧就喺呢個毒品市場出售嘅。 咁我哋會繼續從多個唔同嘅方向咧，希望揾到呢啲可堪嘅來源啦，同埋揾佢哋嗰個分銷點。更加咧，我哋會繼續強化我哋同唔同國家有機會毒品嚟嘅國家咧，有呢個情報交流，加強執法行動嘅。
最後咧，我想喺呢度咧提醒大家市民，特別係咧從事呢個物業管理同埋保安嘅人員。如果你發現有住客咧係運送一啲好重型嘅工具啊或者貨物出入嗰個單位咧，請大家提醒警覺，必須小心觀察。如果發現有可疑嘅咧，可以聯絡警方嘅。
阿陳Madam你好，想問一下咧，呢一個即係集團啦，運作咗幾耐咧？即係佢哋嗰啲嘅可卡因啦，係銷售嘅對象係啲乜嘢嘢啦？同埋頭先就提到揾到嘅一啲嘅製毒工具咧，其實都幾罕見，有幾罕見法咧？即係以往係咪都冇發現咁大批啊？還是係唔見有呢一啲咁嘅工具去用咧？唔該。
咁啊，剛才我講過啦，其中一個被捕嘅男子姓梁嗰位咧，其實係上址嘅租客嚟嘅。咁我哋相信咧，佢哋喺幾個月之前租出。咁我哋嘅情報同埋調查得知咧，相信佢哋運作咗一至兩個月嘅。咁至於可卡因嗰個銷售嘅情況，其實就係有唔同年齡界別嘅香港嘅濫用。毒品嘅人士都會去到佢哋嗰個吸食嗰個範圍嗰度嘅。咁另外咧就係、如果我剛剛講嘅話，呢個千斤頂係罕見咧，我哋翻查翻記錄咧，最近一次檢獲類似嘅呢啲咁嘅液壓千斤頂，已經係2005年嘅事啦。姓陳即係第二個53歲。其實呢一個千斤頂咧，其實個用意咧就係將一啲粉狀或者未成為固體狀嘅咧，將佢壓翻成一嚿磚咁樣。咁就以往咧喺毒品市場上邊咧，好多時我哋發現四號可樂英嗰個做法都係一磚磚嘅。咁點解而家我哋會發現到呢個千斤頂？我諗係販毒嘅人員咧，佢哋想謀取更加多嘅利潤啦。咁所以咧就將啲可堪嘅原料咧混入一啲其他嘅稀釋嘅物質溝埋一齊。咁佢出去個市場都係要用翻磚狀啦，可能咁，所以佢就需要用呢一個工具啦。
係你好啊，有線電視噶，想問翻咧，其實今次係即係根據一啲嘅情報啊，定係即係接獲有一啲嘅即係大廈物業管理公司嘅投訴而揭發呢件事啦，同埋即係之前都有聽過你就有倒破過一啲，就譬如話一啲私人住宅度即係係作為一個即係製毒嘅工場啦。咁其實呢個會唔會係即係今次亦都係喺一個私人住宅度發現啦？其實呢個情況會唔會係即係一啲比較即係？有上升的趨勢咧，咁同埋就係想問翻咧，即係問翻清楚就係頭先話運作咗一至兩個月咧，係成個集團運作咗一至兩個月咧，定係淨係呢一個工場運作咗一至兩個月啊？唔該。
喺呢一次嘅調查嘅呢個案件裏面咧，其實就係並不是收到有任何嘅投訴嘅，係我哋自己嘅情報啦，同埋探員調查翻嚟嘅。其實我喺之前嘅記者會都有講過，其實販毒嘅人士咧會利用唔同嘅方法去避過我哋警方嘅調查，用私人屋苑咧係其中一個辦法。其實佢哋可以喺工業大廈，可以喺村屋，甚至任何地方都可以。咁呢一次喺私人屋苑都唔係第一次啦。咁所以我哋並未留意到特別有咩上升嘅趨勢嘅。我哋相信呢一個單位運作咗一至兩個月。咁剛才所講嘅稀釋劑係第一步毒藥，喺香港嚟講就係喺一個藥劑業及毒藥條例裡面所管轄嘅。
想問翻啊，其實以往咧係咪即係境外包裝成為專藏係比較多，所以咧就發現呢啲嘅工具咧就係比較少見啦。即係同埋呢啲係呢啲工具係佢哋自己自製工具定係點樣㗎？
其實可卡因咧，多數喺我哋嘅經驗或者我哋資料所得咧，大部分都係由南美嚟啦。冇錯嘅，可以係佢哋可以係專藏嚟嘅。咁所以有機會係啲毒販咧，都希望用翻一個專藏嘅形式，就出去賣俾啲吸毒嘅人咯。就再即係一磚咁食唔曬㗎，咁咧就分銷俾一啲人，佢哋會再將佢分細包咁樣賣出去。工具咧，我諗大家應該都會睇到咧，都有啲駁位啊，似乎我唔知佢係咪自製，但係呢一個係特別製造，係俾呢一個用途咯。似乎大家應該睇下都可能會留意到嘅。
想問清楚，即係話呢個工場咧，係佢哋入咗啲可卡因翻嚟，再稀釋，再分銷出去，即係佢唔係純粹。
我諗大家會發現呢度有咁多工具咧，咁就相信咧佢又有嗰啲一包包嘅第一步危險毒藥，相信佢就真係係稀釋出去嘅。咁至於係咪每一個販毒集團都會稀釋出去，或者呢個係咪一個趨勢咧？咁我諗我哋會研究一下嘅。
Madam, how rare are the equipments you found in the flat, and what is so special about these equipments? And secondly, the syndicate, as you said, rented a flat in Changshou to manufacture the drugs. How challenging is it for officers to carry out the investigation?
In this case, we got some special equipment, which we rarely seized. And the latest one was already in the case of 2005, which is the hydraulic jacks, which you can see just right down there. And we always have difficulties or challenges during our investigation, not only this case.
What is so special about this?
As what I said is because for the last case, we seized this kind of jacks was already 2005. That means it's not very commonly used in Hong Kong, the drug trafficking syndicates.
And what does it do?
Oh, you mean the purpose for using it?
Maybe I answer your question. For the different kinds of equipment, you can see that there's a hydraulic jacks. And also, there is a blenders. So first, from our investigation, we see that the drug syndicate used the blenders to mix the cutting agent, that is the part one poison, with cocaine for the purpose of dilution. Subsequently, the mixed cocaine was molded into a brick shake by various equipment, including the hydraulic jacks, the steel mix. Working tables there, and drug molds. So it was believed that the drug syndicate would carry out the diluting process with intent to making a higher profit. And I also want to reiterate that this kind of equipment are very heavy. You can see that as we have mentioned, the hydraulic jet is around 40 pounds. And also for the steel working tables, it's around 400 pounds. So whenever some, for example, security guards or management office practitioners observe that some residents has moved heavy objects, such, for example, such as these objects, they should be alert and report to police at once.
同埋想補問翻少少嘅就係咧，即係個被捕人士咧涉唔涉及三合會背景，同埋即係嗰兩位男士咧會唔會話即係之前都有過同類嘅案底㗎？唔該。
根據我哋嘅資料咧，兩位被捕人都係冇三合會背景嘅，亦都有其他嘅案底咯。前者。 43歲成員。我哋相信佢係其中一個集團嘅成員。咁當日佢同阿姓梁嗰位一齊去，然後一齊出翻嚟，而喺個背囊上邊有裡面有11公斤可卡因，咁所以我哋都係拉佢犯運危險藥物。
即係
我哋喺個行動裡面咧，係喺姓梁個背囊度揾到嘅。但係係咪陪同，又或者佢係咩角色咧？我哋而家查緊。佢係嗰度嘅租客啦，正如我所講，佢自己都有另外一個喺新田嘅一個住宅嘅地方嘅。咁至於佢係唔係日日喺度住，或者佢嗰個逗留喺上址嘅情況咧，呢個都係我哋調查嘅方向嚟嘅。咁或者我補充少少關於嗰個第一步毒藥嗰度啦，其實咧就係佢稀釋落嗰啲可卡因裡面咧，呢個話明係毒藥啦。咁其實佢本身就係一啲止痛藥嚟嘅。咁但係經過我哋嘅調查啦，同埋資料所得咧，如果呢啲真係嗰個第一步毒藥叫非西拿丁咧，咁咧非拿西丁咧，咁長期服食咧係致癌嘅。咁所以咧，吸毒已經係危害身體嘅啦。如果係又吸食可卡因，再長期服用呢一啲咁嘅致癌物質嘅嘢咧，相信會更加影響市民嘅健康。
咩？非拿西丁係咪因為？